Greetings everyone, in this tutorial I will show you how you can real-time face swap your webcam with any face you want by using the most advanced face swapping easy zero-shot deepfake application RobPearl. If you remember RobPearl application, I have made two tutorials for it. So in this tutorial, you will see how to use this amazing application on your Windows computer and do real-time face swapping by using TensorRT model with InSwapper with 512 restoring faces and other features. It will be one-click install and use on your computer very fast with TensorRT. Since I am recording a video with OBS Studio, it is not as fast as it would be without recording a video. So let's begin. As usual, I have prepared detailed instructions and one-click installers. Everything is in this post. The link of this post will be in the description of the video. If you don't know how to use this amazing Rob application, first of all, watch our main Windows tutorial. And if you are going to use it on a cloud, if you don't have a powerful GPU, watch our Massive Compute cloud tutorial first. Then you can watch this tutorial. When you go to the very bottom of the post, you will see three attachment files: Rob version 4, Rob landmarks, and Rob live stream. Now you may be wondering, what does this mean? Rob version 4 is the original main development of the Rob application. Rob landmarks is the version, a fork of the main repository developed by Alucard, and Rob live stream is the latest fork of the Rob application developed by Argenspin. So this is the newest version that supports all of the previous versions, all of the features that the Alucard has or the main repo has. And additionally, this is the fork that has the TensorRT and also webcam feature. So I suggest you to use Rob live stream version. You see, you can click here to download, but I suggest you to download it from attachments, because sometimes there may be mislinking, or I may not put the link into the description. So the attachments is the accurate part where you will download. Okay, after you downloaded the Rob live stream version for zip file, go to the downloads and cut it and paste it into the any hard drive that you want to install. Let's install it into our F drive. Do not install it into your users folder, into Windows folder, or into cloud folders like OneDrive. So extract here, enter inside the extracted folder. Do not have special characters in your folder path, or do not have space characters in your folder path, because it may break the application. Then all you need to do is double click Windows install.bat file. This will install the application fully for you. It will also download all of the necessary modules, which are over 20 different modules. So this will make everything for you. But for this application to work, you need to have several installations. You need to have Python 3.10, you need to have Git, ffmpeg, CUDA 11.8, this is super important, and C++ tools. If you don't know how to install them, I already have a tutorial for that, an amazing tutorial. Let's see that. So click here to see it. This is a 34 minutes tutorial, and in this tutorial you will see all the video chapters. So by following this tutorial, you can install all the requirements. When installing Python, please install into your C drive directly, as I have shown. It is super important. Once you do this installation, you will be able to run all of the newest AI applications without ever having any issues. This is a public tutorial on our channel, so even if you are not my Patreon supporter, you can still watch this tutorial to learn how to install the primary elements of any AI application. So the installation is first cloning the repository. It's a big one with a lot of files, over 200 megabytes. If you encounter any problems related to your internet connection, you can use Warp VPN. It's a free VPN. Just type Warp VPN. This is provided by the Cloudflare, and it should fix your issues with the downloading when you are using the installers. Moreover, all of my installers install into their virtual environment, so they will not affect any other installation on your system. They will be completely isolated. Moreover, you can look the content of every file that I have. Everything is fully transparent. There is nothing pre-compiled or encrypted. The installation of virtual environment is completed. Now it is downloading the necessary modules automatically for us. The downloader script that I have made will not re-download if already completely downloaded, or it will resume if the download were interrupted. So it's a very robust script that you can use for other applications and purposes as well. Alright, the installation is completed. You see virtual environment made and installed properly. But before pressing any key to close this, scroll up and verify that everything is accurately installed. There are no errors. Moreover, right click here, edit, select all, then right click, edit, copy and save all of the installation logs, because if there are any error, you need to email me or message me from Patreon so I can check and see what the error you have. So let's press any key to close this. Let's go back to our installation folder, which is here. Enter inside rob leave. Let's check out the model's total size, which is 5 GB. And before installing the TensorRT, let's start our application. For start, Windows start.bat file, it will start the rob application. Let's make full screen. Okay, I will turn off my webcam so you can see this area as well. So to use this application, watch the Windows tutorial to learn how to use it, but I will show quickly. Let's select videos folder. I already have included some demo images and faces which will be automatically downloaded. Let's open them. Let's also select our save folder into here. And we are ready to testing. So let's select the video. Let's click find faces. Let's change the Brad Pitt face into, for example, this one. So it is not changed yet. Before starting changing, let's set up the parameters. So I'm going to use InSwapper, which is the best. We are going to use CUDA because we didn't install TensorRT yet. You see there is also webcam resolution, which I will show you when I am showing the webcam. Currently I will not show it. I will show it with the TensorRT, but it is not mandatory to use TensorRT. Okay, let's also enable Restorer with GPP GAN. You can also play with this. I have shown everything in the Windows tutorial. And this is very important, setting up the swap resolution 512. Then click swap faces and just wait. If there is any error, you will see it on the CMD window. So the CMD window is very important to see the errors. The interface will freeze whenever it is loading, whenever it is doing something. Okay, you see the face has been changed. Now we can click this play icon and it will start playing the video with changed faces. It is not saving yet. For saving, you need to click this record button to save into the output folder. The speed will depend on your GPU. The VRAM usage is like this. If your VRAM is not sufficient, you can reduce the thread count, which is set here. You see, this is the thread count. Let's make it like 3, for example. So after doing this change, you may be needed to clear VRAM, then click play, and it will reduce the number of threads, so it will use lesser amount of VRAM. Don't forget to change the thread count from here if you have a thread problem. Okay, so now let's install the TensorRT and see the speed. But before doing that, let me show you the 5 thread count speed one more time. So let's click play. So it is playing with this speed. You can see the frames numbers from here. So these are the processed frames right now. So this is the speed of RTX 3090 Ti with thread count 5. Okay, so let's close the application. So you see it's also terminated. Let's click here. Let's return back to our folder. Now all you need to do is double click Windows install TensorRT step 2. This will download the TensorRT files automatically for you, extract into this folder and edit to the environment path automatically for you. So it should work out of box automatically for you. So the TensorRT installation is also completed. Let's check out logs. It is looking accurate. There is no errors or issues. Then press any key to continue. Now let's start back our application again with clicking the start icon. It is started. Once you started the application, click here and it will refresh the folders like this. You see, currently refreshing. Okay, the folders has arrived. Then click find faces, select our face, select swapping face. Let's select TensorRT, enable restorer, change the swapper resolution to 512 and then click swap faces. Now after you click swap faces, when you first time running a configuration, it will generate TensorRT model. However, it is not displayed on the CMD window, so you just need to wait patiently until it is completed. Let's look at the task manager. And we should see that our GPU is being used. You see, it is being used right now to compile TensorRT model. Whenever you make some serious changes in the configuration, it may recompile the TensorRT model. I think it depends on the restorer model and used phase swapping model and some other changes that affects the TensorRT model. So just wait until it is completed. It doesn't take much on my RTX 3090 Ti, but it depends on your GPU. Just wait until the screen freeze has ended. Currently, you see the raw screen is frozen. Meanwhile, let me show you which path parameter added to the system variables. This is important because if it fails on your computer, you need to add manually, but it should be automatically. So open the path from here, and in here you see that the downloaded TensorRT library added. You will see that I already have another one which was from my previous installation, but this is how you add your downloaded TensorRT files into your path variable. Okay, the TensorRT model has been generated, and now you see that the face has been changed. The interface is unfrozen. Now let's see the real-time speed. So let's play and see. Okay, currently it is working with TensorRT, and I can say that yes, it is really, really faster than before. We have restorer enabled. We have GPP GAN enabled. We are using right now. Also, we are using 512 model. And it is really, really fast right now, fast playing. Okay, let's also increase the thread count and see the effect of the TensorRT model. So I'm going to make this 10, then hit enter. So the slider will be applied. Then let's go to the very beginning, click record and click play. And let's see the real-time speed. By the way, I am right now recording video, which is a 4K video. Also, Nvidia broadcast is running, so I have a lot of backend running right now, but the speed is incredible. You see, it is really, really fast while I am doing all of this. VRAM usage is very, very minimal right now, so it is using like 5 GB total, probably lesser than that because there are other applications running at the back. So it is working amazing with TensorRT. This application is now blazing fast. Once you enabled recording, you will see that the video saved as like this. So total time was 56 seconds and the duration of the video, let's open and see again. So the video is saved here. You see test video. Let's open it. So the duration of the video is 21 seconds. So 21 seconds duration video, which is full HD. 1920 to 1080, save it in 55 seconds. Almost real time, not real time, but almost. Now I will show you how you can use webcam feature to real time replace your face. To do that, I need to close my OBS first, then start the webcam here, then I will record. But to be able to do that, you need to have OBS virtual cam. Currently, this is my OBS screen. So you need to click start virtual cam, then stop virtual cam and exit from OBS to be able to start your webcam in your RAW application. Don't forget that. Click start virtual cam, then stop virtual cam, exit your OBS, open your RAW application, start webcam. I will show you how to continue after this. Since this is important, I will show you this as well. You see, after I stopped my OBS and click it start RAW, so that RAW can see my webcam, you see my Kaspersky antivirus warned me about this. So if you have an antivirus, it may block your webcam usage on the RAW application. I will allow, so it will be allowed to use my webcam. However, since OBS running right now, I can't get the webcam, so I will stop the OBS one more time. Okay, so my webcam appeared here. I clicked it, then I click it play button. Now my webcam is displayed on the RAW interface. I started my OBS as well. First of all, before starting webcam and leave webcam testing, make sure that you enable send frames to virtual camera here. So you can reduce your webcam resolution from here to get a maybe more smoother output, maybe more accurate looking output. So you can change your webcam resolution from here. You can change your webcam FPS from here. Now what I'm going to do is enable this again. It was disabled once I changed the resolution. So now we are ready to do leave changing. To do that, look at the camera and click find faces, it will get your face like this. Then you can reduce your similarity threshold to follow your face very accurately from here like this, or maybe like this. Then select the face that you want to change real time. I don't have a compatible face with myself, I didn't look for, so the quality will not be best. However, it should be enough to show you, so I will use this face. Then click swap faces. Then we are going to get a leaf swapping like this. Okay, let's see. Currently this is leaf. On the rope application it is not very well looking, but now I will show you on the virtual camera. Moreover, you can reduce your webcam resolution, you can reduce your FPS if your GPU is not able to keep up with it. You can play with other parameters to get more accurate results, but this is just for showing you. So I will say webcam test like this. Let's open a web page. So you can use this on Google Meeting, wherever you are using. And from here I will select OBS virtual camera. Now this is important, you select OBS virtual camera for live test. Test my cam, you see Google Chrome using, and now it is live. Okay, there is some delay right now with my configuration, and also I am recording a 4K tutorial right now, so it is also using a lot of CPU, GPU power and reducing some FPS. And when I change my face fully, it may get broken, but yeah, you see it is working pretty decent actually. So it is up to you, and we may probably reduce the webcam resolution furthermore, decrease it more, but this is how you can use ROP Pearl real time. So this is real time usage of ROP Pearl. Now there is nothing else left for this tutorial to show. If you are going to use this application on a cloud, the Massive Compute tutorial is fully up to date. Just follow this tutorial to install on Massive Compute. And for using live webcam, I don't know how you can connect webcam to the virtual computer, but the application will work perfectly on there. So you can swap existing videos on Massive Compute very fast. Just follow this tutorial. The installer scripts are already included in the zip file. Currently on Massive Compute on Ubuntu, TensorRT is not working. I couldn't make it work yet, but the CUDA is working very well. You know, when we don't have TensorRT, we use CUDA with NVIDIA GPU. And if you don't have any NVIDIA GPU, you can use CPU, but it will be super slow. The CPU will be super slow. So this is how you use. You can always message me on Patreon. Also join our Discord channel and ask me any questions that you want. We also have now Reddit subreddit. You can join our Reddit subreddit. I will share a lot of useful stuff here. And to find our Discord channel, just click this link. You can also type this to the Google to join our Discord channel. You see software engineering courses, SE courses. We have over 7,000 members. I reply every message on Discord, every email, every Patreon comment, everything. I am full-time dedicating myself to you guys. Thank you so much for watching, sharing, liking. Please also star our GitHub repository. You see when you click here, you will go to our GitHub repository. Star it, fork it, watch it. If you sponsor me, I appreciate that. So hopefully see you another next amazing tutorial video. Bye.